بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. The creed, the correct creed regarding the family of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. It is from the creed of Ahlul Sunnah that we love the family of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And we know of their merits and of their honor. All the members of the household of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Ahlul Sunnah, Ahlul Islam, love them. In accordance with the bequest of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام on the day of Ghadir Hum, where he praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and described Allah in all that is that he deserves of praise. And admonished the believers and reminded them. Then he said afterwards, أما بعد, it proceeds then, ألا أيها الناس, O people, فإنما أنا بشر, I am only human. يوشك أن يأتي رسول ربي فأجيب. The messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may come, meaning the angel of death, and I would respond. وأنا تارك فيكم ثقلين. I am leaving you, I'm leaving amongst you two weighty matters, two weighty things. أولهما كتاب الله, one of which is the book of Allah. فيه الهدى والنور, therein is guidance and light. فخذوا بكتاب الله, so hold firm to the book of Allah, واستمسكوا به, and it is the rope of Allah. He who holds to it would be on right guidance, and he who abandons it would be in error. ثم قال, then after exhorted us and admonished us to hold firm to the book of Allah, then he said, وَأَهْلُ بَيْتِي, the second are the members of my household. أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهَ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي, أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهَ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي, أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهَ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي, I remind you of the duties to the members of my household. I remind you of the duties to the members of my household. I remind you of the duties to the members of my household. This hadith is reported by Muslim in his Sahih from Zayd bin Arqam. May Allah be pleased with him. Imam Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, mentioned in his tafsir, and we don't deny what the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام bequeathed regarding his household family members, and to be good to them, and to respect them, and to honor them, because they are a pure offspring from the most honorable house on the first of earth, in honor and lineage. especially إذا كانوا متبعين للسنة النبوية الصحيحة الواضحة الجلية, especially if they are followers of the authentic and clear Sunnah. As their early predecessors were upon, like Al-Abbas and his sons, and Ali and his family and his offspring. May Allah be pleased with them all. The end of Imam Ibn Kathir's statement, Rahimahullah. And from his household is his wives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the context of addressing them in Surah Al-Ahzab in chapter 33 verse 34, وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ وَلَا تَبَرَّجْنَ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ الْأُولَى وَأَقِمْنَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتِينَ الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِعْنَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجس أهل البيت. Let's have 33 in the beginning, then 34, please. ويطهركم تطهيرا واذكرن ما يتلى في بيوتكن من آيات الله والحكمة إن الله كان لطيفا خبيرا. And stay in your houses and don't display yourselves like that of the times of ignorance. And perform as-salah, establish the prayers, and give zakah, and obey Allah and His Messenger. Allah wishes only to remove ar-rijs, evil deeds and sins from you, O members of the family of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and to purify you with a thorough purification. And remember, O you members of the Prophet's family, the graces of Allah that which is recited in your houses, of the verses of Allah and the hikmah, the sunnah. Verily Allah is uppermost courteous, well acquainted with all things. Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said, Imam Ibn Kathir said in his tafsir, in his explanation, هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ, listen to this carefully please, هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ, this verse, نَصٌ في دخول أزواج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في أهل البيت ها هنا. This is a textual proof of the inclusion of the wives of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the family members of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. They are here because لأنهن سبب نزول الآية, because they were the cause behind the revelation of this verse. So also within this ayah as well is included Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers, Ali bin Abi Talib, and Fatima, the daughter of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and al-Hasan and al-Husayn. May Allah be pleased with all of them. Because of the hadith reported by Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her and her father, she said, خرج رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم غداة وعليه مرط مرحل من شعر أسود. He صلى الله عليه وسلم went out one morning wearing a stripped cloak of the black camel's hair, that there came فجاء الحسن بن علي. Then there came Al-Hasan, the son of Ali. فأدخله. He wrapped him under it. ثم جاء الحسين. فدخل معه. Then came Al-Husayn, the son of Ali. And he wrapped him under it, along with the other one, along with the Hasan. ثم جاءت فاطمة. فأدخلها. Then Fatima came and he took her under it. ثم جاء علي فأدخله. Then came Ali, and he also took him under it. ثم قال, then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم recited the verse 33 above. إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجس أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes only to remove الرجس, evil deeds and sins from you, O members of the family of the Prophet, and to purify you with a thorough purification. And this hadith is reported in Sahih Muslim. This is what is referred to in this book, which we are discussing, the book of the correct creed. I would like to add the following from the words of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala concerning this matter, and which he mentioned in his classical book on the creed, which is called Al-Wasitiyyah, He rahimahullah said, and Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah love the members of the household of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, regard them as friends, and protect the will of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about them, which he had stated on the day of Ghadir al-Qum, Ghadir al-Qum. I will talk about what is this Ghadir al-Qum. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I remind you of Allah about my Ahlul Bayti household. And this is in Sahih Muslim. And said to his uncle Al-Abbas, when it was complained that some people of Quraysh are oppressing Bani Hashim, you know, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is from Bani Hashim. He said, I swear by the one who holds my soul in his hand, that these people cannot be believers until they love you and my relatives. And this is in Tirmidhi. He also said, Allah chose Bani Ismail, the offspring of Ismail, and from Bani Ismail, he chose Bani Kanana. And from Bani Kanana, he chose the Quraysh. And from Quraysh, he chose Bani Hashim. And he chose me from Bani Hashim. And this is in Sahih Muslim. Ahlul Sunnah regard the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with reverence on the ground that they were like mothers of the believers. They have a faith that these will be the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hereafter also. Particularly Khadija, who is the mother of most of his children and was the first among the faithful ones. She cooperated with him in his work and she enjoyed a high status due to him. And As-Siddiqa, Bint As-Siddiq, the truthful one, the daughter of the truthful one, may Allah be pleased with her and her father, about whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, quote, Aisha has a superiority over all other women in the same way as the farid, this is a type of food, good food, has superiority all other foods. And this is in Bukhari. Ahlul Sunnah express their disassociation from the way of Ar-Rawafid. Ar-Rawafid, these are the extremist sects of the Shia, who gave up Zayd bin Ali, the son of Hussein. Who gave up Zayd bin Ali, the son of Hussein, when he showed love to Abu Bakr and Umar. May Allah be pleased with both of them. They disregarded him in Kufa, in Iraq, in the same way as they have done with his grandfather, al-Hussein. So Shaykh al-Islam said, Ahlul Sunnah express their disassociation from the way of the Rawafid, these extremist Shia, for they keep malice against the companions and revile them, and also from the ways of An-Nawasib. An-Nawasib, they are the people who have enmity to the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who slander them and consider them disbelievers. Nowadays, these don't exist. Shaykh al-Islam now says also, and also from the ways of An-Nawasib, who inflict pain on the family hold of the Prophet ﷺ by word or act, and keep themselves uninvolved into the differences that arose among the companions. Ahlul Sunnah believe that the narratives reported about the shortcomings of the companions are either false or have been exaggerated or reduced or perverted. I would like to repeat this important statement. He said, Ahlul Sunnah believe that the narrations reported about the shortcomings of the companions are either false or have been exaggerated or reduced or perverted. The right stand, he continues, the right stand in this connection is that they, the companions, are excused. Either they grasped the correct position by ijtihad, by way of deduction, or they committed a mistake. Along with this, the Ahlul Sunnah don't believe that every companion is innocent of the minor or major sins, but rather it is possible in general, that they can commit sin, but they have some such superiorities and virtuous deeds to their credit, which cause the pardon of the errors committed by them. Allahu Akbar. Let me repeat. He said, Sayyid Alhamdulillah, the right stand in this connection is that they, the Sahaba, companions, are excused. Either they grasp the correct position by way of ijtihad, of deduction, of the ruling, or they committed a mistake. Along with this, Ahlul Sunnah don't believe that every companion is innocent of the minor or major sins, but rather it is possible in general that they can commit sin, but they have some such superiorities and virtuous deeds to their credit, which cause the pardon of the errors committed by them. Even those errors of theirs will be pardoned, which will not be pardoned if committed by the people of the latter period. Even those errors of theirs will be pardoned, which will not be pardoned if committed by the people of the latter period. The reason is that they have to their credit such virtues to compensate for the errors which the people who came later don't have. Then this is the statement by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. And there is the following commentary on this by al-Shaykh al-Doktor Muhammad Khalil al-Harras rahimahullah ta'ala, who had an excellent explanation and discussion of this book, which is called Al-Wasitiyya for Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. He said, rahimahullah, his commentary on the statements that you have heard. He said, Ahlul Bayt, the family members of the Prophet ﷺ, are those on whom zakah, obligatory charity, is prohibited. And these are the family of Ja'far, the family of Aqil, and the family of Al-Abbas. All of these belong to Bani Hashim. And these include Banu al-Muttalib. For the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, إِنَّهُمْ لَمْ يُفَارِقُونَ جَاهِلِيَّةً وَلَا إِسْلَامًا. They have left us neither during the period of ignorance nor in the period of Islam. Reported by An-Nasa'i. For this reason, Ahlul Sunnah respect the Ahlul Bayt, the family members, and pay due regard to their relationship with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, exactly as they love them for the trial they underwent in helping Islam, the religion of Allah, and were the precursors of the religion. The word which we came across, which is called Ghadiru Hum, has been used because Khum was the name of a person who was a dyer, dyer, D-Y-E-R, by occupation. And the word Ghadir has been related to him. And this is a pond, P-O-N-D, at Al-Juhfa, which is between Mecca and Medina. Another statement is that Khum is a name of a tree towards which Ghadir has been ascribed. The Prophet ﷺ said to his uncle, quote, I swear by the one who holds my life in his possession, that these people cannot become believers unless they love me, and because of my kinship, love you for the sake of Allah. And this means that no one's faith can acquire perfection until he loves for the sake of Allah the family of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The reason is that they are from amongst those friends of Allah and his obedient people whose love and friendship for Allah is obligatory. Also because they have a kinship relation with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam are those with whom he contracted nikah, marriage. The first among is Khadija bint Khuwaylid, whom he married in Mecca before being entrusted with prophethood. The Prophet ﷺ was 25 years old at that time, and she was older than him by 15 years. He did not marry another woman during her lifetime. Except for Ibrahim, all his children were born to her. She was the first to have faith in him and provided him with strength in sustaining the burden of prophethood. She died at the age of 65, 3 years before the Hijrah, before the migration. After her, he married Sauda bint Zam'a and then performed the nuptial ceremony with Aisha, N-U-P-T-I-A-L. At that time, Aisha was 6 years old. She came to the Prophet's house after the Hijrah to Al-Madinah when she had become 9 years old. One of his wives is Ummu Salama, may Allah be pleased with all of them, whom he married after the death of Abu Salama, her husband. Another is Zainab bin Jahsh, whom he married after she had been divorced by Zayd bin Haritha. The fact is that this marriage took place under a special plan of Allah, as this is mentioned in the Quran. Additionally, Juwayriya bint al-Harith, Safiya bint Huyay, Hafsa bint Umar, and Zainab bint Khuzaima, all are his wives and mothers of the believers. These are his wives in the hereafter also. These are his wives in the hereafter also. Khadija and Aisha are unconditionally superior to them all. Unlike the Rawafid, the rejectionist Shia, Ahlus Sunnah disassociate themselves from the extremist position in favor of Ali, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Rawafid, the rejectionist of the Shia, keep an animus with the senior companions. They revile them and call them kafirs. The name Rawafid, rejectionists, was given to them first of all by Zayd when the Shia asked him to dissociate himself from the obedience to the two Shaykhs Abu Bakr and Umar so that the Shia might offer bay'ah allegiance to him. He refused to do so. When they left his company, he said, رَفَضْتُمُونِي. This is the name, the Rafida, how it came. He said, رَفَضْتُمُونِي. You have left me. They began to be called Rafida from that day. They have a large number of sects, some more extremist than others. Ahlus Sunnah also dissociate themselves from the way of An-Nawasib also, who developed hostility against the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on account of certain known political dimensions. Now they don't exist at present anymore. Ahlul Sunnah do not go into verifications. Ahlul Sunnah, listen carefully please. Ahlul Sunnah do not go into verifications of the mutual differences that took place among the companions, particularly after the assassination of Uthman, among Ali, Talha, and Zubair, and also the latter events that took place between Ali, Muawiyah, and Amr ibn al-As. Ahlul Sunnah believe that whatever narratives have been narrated about their shortcomings, are often false or have been perverted. Of course, regarding those that are true, they consider them excused and say that they occupy in it the position of mujtahid, the one who exerts the effort to reach a conclusion or a hukum or a ruling. Despite this, they don't believe that the companions are innocent of the minor and the major sins in general, but their superiorities and feats and the company they kept with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the jihad they carried out along with him justify their pardon. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa sallallahu ala muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. This concludes this important matter concerning the creed of Ahlul Sunnah regarding the household members of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, the believing one. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa sallallahu ala muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.